Increased transparency is great for every stakeholder within the supplement industry, correct? Ask any leader within the vitamins, minerals, and supplements industry, and they will mention that there is a clear connection between increased transparency and consumer trust. As more consumers add supplements into their daily routine, the belief is that it is imperative every player within the value chain embrace a greater level of transparency to ensure that only high-quality supplements enter the market in order to reduce the risk to consumers. Now, I'm totally on board with this line of thinking, and I think most supplement brands and anybody that's on the supply side of the vitamins, minerals, and supplements industry, they tend to agree as well. But let's kind of dig in, and maybe not everybody should be as excited unless they're going to do the needed work to actually benefit from this. In today's age of information, supplement buyers, if they choose to, are more educated on pretty much any item that they would want to buy within the category. While transparency is definitely an evolutionary standard, the brand side of the supplements industry has mostly obliged with this consumer demand for increased information. And just to give you guys like a pretty simple example, if you look at maybe 2011, you walk into a GNC, maybe you go over to the pre-workout section, odds are most of the products on those shelves would be filled with a bunch of proprietary formulas. You don't really know exactly what is in the product. Now, you take that same trip 10 years later in 2021, you pick up a pre-workout product, turn it around, look at the supplements facts panel, you're gonna see a ton, if not most, of the brands that have transparent labels, fully disclosed labels that provide you an understanding of what would be in the product. Now, supplement brands have historically used their level of transparency as some type of marketing differentiation point. But what was transparent in 2011 or 2017 or even today is not necessarily anything outside the market expectations in the near future. Supplement brands know that consumers base their purchases not only on the product's effectiveness and quality, but also other elements like the company's transparency efforts or maybe their sustainability efforts. Supplement brands also definitely need to continue to push the envelope on differentiation points in a very competitive industry. And that combination will create opportunities for supplement brands that definitely want to put in the required work and push the boundaries on current consumer expectations around transparency to stand out. Now take the example of the villain of the supplements industry, Amazon, and kind of look at what they're doing to really push the envelope here on transparency and eliminating the number one kind of hurdle for the category around consumer trust. Accompanying each one of the Amazon private label products around their vitamins, minerals, and supplements, either on the packaging or the listing that can easily be found, you will see who the contract manufacturer of that specific lot number and that bottle. There will be a certificate of analysis for each product that is easily found through a QR code. They also provide some insights on each of the tests within the products that are being performed, information around why and how each product is created, some of the ingredients origins, and a Q&A that addresses concerns such as use of maybe some synthetic ingredients, excipients, or kind of some other ingredients that maybe people would have questions around. Without a doubt, Amazon is pushing the industry forward towards a greater level of transparency. If these products continue to become popularized, it creates a new set of expectations similar to what Amazon has done with shipping windows and a number of other things. They've pushed things forward, and then you either match or beat Amazon, or you're going to be looked at as you are not staying with the market expectations. And these changes that Amazon are making really show the industry as a whole what is going to be valued and what consumers would be willing to pay for around some of the benefits and peace of mind that they would get with this elevated level of transparency. Because of that, supplement brands will gradually need to respond more to this But this isn't exactly what I'm talking about, where the problem lies. I actually want to talk about this from the supply side. Supplement brands will start to demand the supply side to provide them more transparency. So this could be from contract manufacturers, this could be from ingredient suppliers, this could be from some of the flavor suppliers. Brands will start to want to disclose a lot more information because they know this elevated level of transparency will help them foster long-term brand loyalty, which is hard to come by in the vitamins, minerals, and supplements industry. However, this will be a lot easier said than done. Eventually, transparency will turn into full-blown traceability. And traceability is a buzzword within the industry that you've probably heard a lot of, but really doesn't have a consistent definition or standard. That being said, traceability systems are intended to track a flow of materials through the supply chain and are mainly made of documentation and the supporting legwork done to create and verify those documents. Ultimately, full traceability is going to be a very large, tough undertaking within agricultural-based products. But it's already starting to happen now with some food products based around maybe societal questions or maybe the government stepping in and saying it needs to have more regulation to help cut down some foodborne illnesses. It will also continue to get easier as technology becomes more ubiquitous within the food supply chain. Without a doubt, the supply side of the vitamins, minerals, and supplements industry will respond and definitely provide brands the opportunity to have full traceability. But what will happen next might catch a lot of the supply side off guard. Let's fast forward not too far in the future where full traceability is happening within the supplements market. Now, anyone that has been to a supply side conference or trade show will notice something pretty quickly, especially if you are somebody like myself that has spent a ton of my career on the brand side of the industry and a lot closer to the end consumer. You will see that these supply side companies are terrible at things like marketing, branding, and really anything outside of maybe the science or operational capabilities that are really used to differentiate themselves from a B2B sales perspective. Because they are selling to the supplement brands that then do a lot of the storytelling to the end consumer, they haven't really had to be all that great at some of these things. They're really focused around providing value propositions that maybe are outside of what a end consumer would be focused on. But these things that never really mattered all that much will become extremely important very soon. Consider what is happening now within the supplement industry with a brand like Ghost Lifestyle. And I'm going to use them as an example because one, they're good friends. Two, they actually are extremely open in terms of a lot of the elements that I'm going to talk about. And it's just kind of easiest to use them as an example because you could go in, trace some of the documentation that they've had over the last several years. But they are open and show on some of their social media, or you can easily search this across the internet, who their contract manufacturer is, which is Armada Nutrition. They also talk about their flavor company at different times with Synergy Flavors. They also talk about some of ingredient suppliers. They also talk about who is making their packaging. And while all that information is not necessarily on the hard physical packaging for Ghost Lifestyle's products today, it's very likely that they will be at some time in the near future. That means when you have something that says manufactured at Armada Nutrition, that needs to mean something to Ghost Lifestyle and the customers of Ghost Lifestyle. Because if it doesn't, and it provides some red flags and questions, Ghost Lifestyle is going to have to answer those questions and have some very good sound reasons why they're working with them over another contract manufacturer that maybe has a higher level of perceived value within the consumer market. Now take that example and replace Armada Nutrition with Synergy, or maybe Glambia on the whey protein side, Carnosine on the beta-alanine side, maybe we're talking about Creapure on the creatine side, or XYZ packaging, or et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. As the end consumers of these supplement products start to learn more about the supply side companies, they will start to place market value like anything else they do with the consumer brands that they purchase. And they will care about things that are outside of the scientific or operational aspects and into things like what is the company's core values, what societal causes do these supply side businesses stand for, maybe what the ownership level or leadership level, are they aligned with what societal causes they champion, and is there anything within that company's history that maybe doesn't line up with what they're saying today? Should they need to answer some of those questions in the market? Any noticeable red flags will put these brands like Ghost Lifestyle in a position that they're going to have to justify any suppliers that they utilize. And though a company like Ghost Lifestyle might already be pretty thoughtful in the way they approach their partner supplier relationships, I'll say that that's not necessarily the case with most of the vitamins, minerals, and supplements industry. And as they know that they're going to have to answer those questions, this is going to become a disruptive force. A lot of companies are going to shift their suppliers to ensure that they have a product that is best positioned for the full traceability future of the industry. So these supply side companies right now really need to dig in and think a little bit deeper and consider, how are they going to stand out to end consumers? What is their business going to mean to the end consumers? How are they going to be positioned with them, not just with the B2B companies that they've been working with? And anytime I'm given the opportunity to talk to supply side companies over the last so many years, I've talked about this with them, that they need to get themselves out of the boring middle and only sell on the same value propositions to the B2B side that everybody else is. They need to think about themselves as a consumer brand. They have to think about themselves as a media company, quote unquote, that sells X. Every company is going to need to get to that point as the internet really disrupts and decentralizes everything. And anybody that wants to look at what the future is going to be like, they can look at industry after industry and see that the boring middle has been washed out completely. Either you are going to be on the economical side of things, or you're going to be on the premium side of things. So I would say is to heed my advice now before you're forced to catch up later. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you want to help support me, make sure you guys hit that thumbs up button on this video. If this is the first time you've been introduced to my videos, would love for you guys to be a part of my community by subscribing to my channel. I upload several videos just like this weekly. And if you guys want to connect further outside of this platform, I do include all of my social media links down below. I just want to thank you guys again for your time. Hopefully I gave you some value in return, and we'll see you guys on the next video.